be a blessing if we obey commandments of the Lord.
So if we obey the commandments of the Lord, my sister, God says we'll be blessed. Listen to the words of God, because we've been so trained to just take what the pastor say and run with it. We don't know the Bible says. So let's read that from the top again. But the commandments of God, which God just says, beware that you don't forget God. And how you forget God is when you separate yourself from the commandments. Meaning you don't apply them or know them. That means we separate from God. Thus saith the Bible. Read.
A blessing if ye obey the commandments of the Lord.
Your God.
So read it again from the top.
I set before you this day a blessing and a curse.
So what comes with the commandments, my sister, is a blessing if you keep it and a curse if you don't keep it. Read.
A blessing if ye obey the commandments of the Lord your God.
Sister, I'm bringing you in. What's your name?
April.
So God says you'll be blessed if you keep the commandments. Because a lot of our people are running around saying we're blessed, 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 blessed. But guess what? We're being shot down in the streets like dogs on camera. But yet our people are blessed.
Right.
Breonna Taylor got murdered sleeping in her bed. No officers was charged except for the one that missed her and hit the wall. So the wall has more significance than the life of a black woman. Right. That's what the Lord is saying. But yet we're all blessed.
Right.
Read.
Which I command you this day, and a curse if you will not obey the commandments of the Lord your God.
So April, God says now, if we don't obey the commandments of God, we will be cursed. Did your pastor ever tell you that, April? Now, April, you said you learned some of the laws, right? So now, being that God says in accordance with the law, if you keep them, you're blessed. If you break them, you're cursed, right? If you don't know the commandments, right, sis? Will you be able to apply them?
No, if you don't know.
Correct. Now check this out. Give me what I want. You're going to do the right. You right? Now check out this law, because maybe you haven't heard it. All right? Because I know a lot of people don't, because look around. It's a common practice today, because we have a society, we have separated ourselves from God. We don't know God anymore. What we learned is that was religion. And we love the idols of every religion. Read.
Deuteronomy chapter 22, verse 5. The woman shall not wear that which pertaineth unto a man.
So God says, April, a woman shall not wear. We're going in terms of dress code of God. He says, the woman shall not wear what belongs to a man. Have you heard that before? So what is that law talking about?
Cross-dressing.
Sister April, you're absolutely correct. Now, what is it? Read it again.
The woman shall not wear that which pertaineth unto a man.
So April, you're absolutely correct. God is saying he is not a fan of cross-dressing. He never ordained cross-dressing. April, see, you're correct. So now, what is the article of clothing that women wear that was made for men? April, you're 100% correct. Now, we got to tell the other sisters that, because a lot of them don't believe that. They say this is women's pants. You understand what I'm saying, April? But you're correct. So, all praise that you can understand that, because a lot of people fight with that. But we don't.
Neither shall a man put on a woman's garment.
So now, God also says, in regards to the men, a man should not be cross-dressing either. So what are women's garments that men wear today? I know you look on TV, you see all these shows. They wear skirts, right? They wear heels. You know what I'm saying? So, April, you're on point. Now, is that it? Oh, we are.
For all that do so are abomination unto the Lord thy God.
And God says, every man that cross-dress, every woman that cross-dress are what?
Abomination unto the Lord thy God.
Sister April, you know what abomination means? You know what the word abomination means? God says, a cross-dressing man and a cross-dressing woman are abominations. Hey, can you get the definition for me, abominations? We're going to show it, because, again, our people don't know vocabulary. We were brought here as slaves. We learned English, which is not our rightful language. We learned that by force, along with the customs that came with it. We learned Christmas, Easter, Thanksgiving, religion like Baptist, Pentecostal, so on and so forth, right? But here's what abomination means.
Abomination, a thing that causes disgust or hatred.
So a thing that disgusts God and God hates. So when he looks down from heaven and sees his sisters cross-dressing and the men cross-dressing, God hates that thing, that's it. So it's a thing that God hates, all right, April? Now, if God hates something, right, what do you think the judgment will be? You think God will kill someone for wearing pants? You think God is that petty? No? Let's see. Give me that. Yeah, give me that stuff. Let's see what God says about that, April, right? Because, again, we have separated ourselves from God, so we no longer understand what God wants or who he is. We love religion, April, which you're going to find out. Religions have nothing to do with God. Read.
Zephaniah chapter 1, verse 8. And it shall come to pass.
When it says come to pass, meaning future prophecy, because judgment didn't come on the earth yet. So this say, when it shall come to pass, meaning future judgment. Read.
In the day of the Lord's sacrifice.
The day of the Lord's sacrifice is the second coming of Christ, April. Read.
God will punish.
God will what?
Punish.
So April, in the future, when Christ returns, he's coming for punishment or judgment. Read.
The princes and the king's children.
He said princes and the king's children. So us as a people, we can't relate to royalty anymore. That's how low we have fallen in society. That's how destroyed we are. We can't equate ourselves to royalty. But God says when he comes back, he's going to punish princes and what?
And the king's children.
And the king's children. Because God has a people on this earth that are royal, that he made separate, that he gave laws to. But because we have learned false doctrines, we no longer understand God. We have the Bible present, but the pastors don't teach you the Bible. They have the Bible in the churches, but they teach you what they learn in seminary school. The ideology of the Europeans that conquered you. You understand, April? But we're going to read the Bible. Read.
And all such as are clothed with strange apparel.
So, April, God says he's going to punish all the princes and king's children and all such that are clothed, April. Clothed in what?
Strange apparel.
So, what God calls strange apparel, April, is a man wearing a skirt, dress, high heels, bra, panties, whatever pertains to a woman. And what he calls strange is a woman wearing men's clothing, pants. So that's what we're going over right now, right? God says he hates that thing. But my question to April is, do you think God will kill a man for cross-dressing or a woman for cross-dressing? April said no. So we're reading here that God says he will punish them when he returns, right? So now, my sister's shaking her head. I like, sister, you believe that God is that petty? He will kill you for cross-dressing, my sister over there? She said no too. So let's see. So let's look into when Christ come back. Give me that in Isaiah 624. Let's see, because he said he will punish, right? When he returns, he will punish. Let's see what God will do. Because, again, we have forgotten God, April. We got a degree in religion. We're all doctors of religion. God hates the sin and not the sinner. But, April, those are all lies. Read.
This is Isaiah chapter 66, verse 15. For behold, the Lord will come with fire and with his chariots like a whirlwind.
You hear what God says? He's going to come with fire and what?
And with his chariots like a whirlwind to render his anger with fury and his rebuke with flames of fire.
So God is going to render his anger, because remember, abomination means great hatred. So God is going to visit with anger with what? Fire, April. What do you do with fire, April? You burn. So what people don't understand, there's a time that coming. Give me Zechariah 14. Let's see what the prophet Zechariah, because all the prophets showed all what happened. So he's going to give you a little detail, because what we need, because we don't respect God. So we need to learn details about what the judgment is. And in April, don't lose the thought, we're addressing clothing now. Christ said he would punish the prince and the king's children, right? Now we read that God is going to come back by fire with anger, right? Read.
This is Zechariah chapter 14, verse 12. And this shall be the plague wherewith the Lord will smite all the people that have fought against Jerusalem.
Because guess what, April? We have nations on this earth that are in opposition of God and God's people, April. That's why the scripture says the earth is given into the hands of the wicked. Wicked nations rule this world, April. All right? Read.
Their flesh shall consume away while they stand upon their feet.
April, you hear what God says? He said that fire that Christ is going to come back with is going to be so hot that your flesh will what?
consume their head while they stand upon their feet.
Meaning that heat is going to be so hot, your flesh is going to melt away, just your skeleton will be standing. That's how hot that flame is going to come. Read.
And their eyes shall consume away in their holes.
Sister April, God says your eyes are going to melt away in the socket. That's how hot that flame is going to be when judgment comes forth. Read.
And their tongue shall consume away in their mouth.
He says your tongue is going to melt away in your mouth. So all that's going to be left, April, is skeleton standing. That's how hot that flame is going to be, right? Because we break the commandments of God, April. So curses come upon us. But April, check this out real quickly. Because remember, the judgment says the prince children, the princes and the king's children. Because what we don't understand, April, is that there is no such thing as equality when it came to God.
Right.
He has favorites.
Right.
He created, like for example, of all the birds, the dove is his favorite. Of all the flowers, he loved the lily. So guess what? Of all the nations created, he has a chosen people. Do you know who they are according to the Bible? I like that. You said who? That's a good thing. Give me that real quick. You got it?
This is Isaiah chapter 41, verse 8.
Again, we're reading the Bible because we've all thought, oh, God loved the whole world. We're all equal. But that's not what the Bible actually says. God says we must believe on him as the scripture has said, not what the pastor feels. Read.
But thou, Israel, art my servant.
Who? Israel, my sister. If you look over here, the nation of Israel is lost on this earth right now because they suffered a curse known as slavery from God. So on your left side is what God calls us, and to the right is what our oppressors who conquered us call us. Whether you got conquered by the English, the French, Spain, this is what they call us. So what is your nationality on your father's side? Because God says the male carries the seed. So there's no mixed race according to God. What your father is what you are. You may look like, as far as features, but God don't look at the features. You look at the bloodline. You understand? So what your father is what you are. All right, sis? So look over here, and while we finish the scripture, let me know, where do you fit in? All right, what tribe you would be, okay? You do know the father? No problem. I'm going to give you another solution to that in a second, right? Read.
But thou, Israel, art my servant, Jacob, whom I have chosen, the seed of Abraham, my friend.
So, Sister April, you hear who God has chosen? Did you hear what nation God chose? I saw you got distracted by you, but pay attention. Read it again.
But thou, Israel, art my servant, Jacob, whom I have chosen, the seed of Abraham, my friend.
So it says, but Israel are the servants of God, and Jacob, whom I have chosen. Give me Genesis 32. You know what I want, right? When his name was changed. God mentions Israel and Jacob. Have you heard of the name Jacob before Israel? Who is Jacob?
I've heard his name.
You heard his name? April is good because, again, what I like about you, you're honest. God likes humble spirits because a lot of our people, they're prideful. They don't want to acknowledge, they don't know. And God says, our people are destroyed for lack of knowledge. So because you have the humble spirit, that's why we come out here to answer questions. So let's show you who Jacob is. Jacob is the descendant of Abraham. Isaac, right? Abraham, right? You know Abraham from Abraham? He married Sarah. They had a son called Isaac, right? Isaac married Rebekah and had a son called Jacob and Esau. So, but the covenant, as far as the blessing and the rulership of this earth, was given from Abraham to Isaac to Jacob, and it went to Jacob's 12 sons, which makes up the nation of Israel. So we're going to go into the Bible and show you that real quickly. Read.
Genesis chapter 32, verse 28. And he said, thy name shall be called no more Jacob.
So this is the angel talking to Jacob, right? Because we went here to show you who is Israel and who is Jacob. Read.
But Israel, for as a prince has no power with God.
Notice, he says, your name shall no longer be called Jacob, but Israel, right? And now he's going to explain what it means. For what?
For as a prince.
He says, for as a prince, because God declared this bloodline royalty. Israel means prince of the power of God. That's what it means. So there's a nation on earth that literally are the descendants of God. Literally. You understand that, sis? Read.
For as a prince has the power with God and with men, and has prevailed.
So Israel, sis, means prince of the power. Now, the sister says she doesn't know who her father is. Right, April? So, the Bible left hints and clues. Give me Romans 8. My man is on point. Read.
Romans chapter 8, verse 16.
So April. Because April, like many of us, don't know who their parents are. That's how far we are separated from the commandments of God. Because one of the commandments was marriage. If we applied that law, there would not be no single parent household. Men and women will not be raised, never knowing who their father was if we applied that one commandment. So April is a result, like many of us, of us not keeping the commandments of God. Read.
Romans chapter 8, verse 16. The Spirit itself bears witness.
April, this is how you're going to learn if you are a child of God or not, right? It says the Spirit itself, what?
Bears witness with our spirit.
With our spirit, because this Bible is the Spirit. So what God is saying, he's going to show you prophecies of what will happen to the children of God. So you would know in your spirit, wait a minute, my ancestors matches exactly what the Bible said would only come upon the children of God, or the Jews, or the Israelites, or the descendants of Jacob. You understand, April? Is that clear?
Yes.
So let's go into the records to see what happened. Give me Deuteronomy 28. The book of Deuteronomy, right, takes place after Exodus. In the book of Exodus, God sent Moses into Egypt. Egypt was the world power at that time, right? And under Egypt was God's children in slavery. Just like in 1492, God's children went into slavery again when the conquistadors came here and enslaved the so-called Latinos and Native Indians. Then we were on the west coast of Africa in the 1600s. They brought us all over the world to slavery, the Negroes. But the point is, my sister, we're going to see if the spirit that God, the record that God left, bear witness with your spirit, right? So if your ancestors fit these curses that will only come upon the nation of Israel or God's children or the Jews, then it will tell you, Sister April, who you are today. You follow me? Brother, you follow me? Read that.
Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 15. But it shall come to pass, if thou wilt not hearken unto the voice of the Lord thy God, to observe to do all his commandments and his statutes, which I command thee this day, that all these curses shall come upon thee and overtake thee.
So what? What Moses was doing after he delivered us from captivity, from slavery, he's warning us, April, right? He gave us the laws and said, if you guys don't obey these laws, curses will come upon you, April. You got that so far? That's option B, right? Give me verse 1.
Verse 16.
Verse 1.
Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 1. And it shall come to pass, if thou shalt hearken diligently unto the voice of the Lord thy God, to observe and to do all his commandments, which I command thee this day, that the Lord thy God will set thee on high above all nations.
So the flip side was, if we kept the commandments, God says the nation of Israel will sit above all nations, right? Read.
Above the earth.
So, if we kept the commandments, April, I want to make sure you follow me. If we kept the commandments of God, we will be blessed above all nations. If we broke the commandments, curses will come upon us. So it's the opposite. Based on us applying the commandments or not applying, it's blessing if we keep it, curses if we keep it. You follow me? April, you got that?
Yeah.
Give me where it says the curse shall be assigned. I think it's 36, 45, something like that. 46, read.
This is Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 46. And they shall be upon thee for a sign and for a wonder, and upon thy seed forever.
April, you heard what God says? So he says the curses, right? Because the options were, if we kept the commandments, we would be blessed and be above all nations. If we broke them, curses will come upon us. Give me Daniel 9 and 11. Hold on. So let's see which one back then we chose. Let's see if the nation of Israel kept the commandments of God, April, or they broke them, all right? Because God says if they keep them, they're going to be blessed. If they broke them, what will happen?
they'll be cursed. It's important that we learn to listen, we learn God's language, his definitions. If we keep the commandments, bless above all nations. We break the commandments, curses below all nations. You follow me? Read.
Daniel chapter 9, verse 11. Yea, all Israel have transgressed thy law.
So all Israel has broken the commandments. That's what happened. So when Moses laid down the law, if we keep them, we're blessed, we rule. If we break them, we're cursed, we're on the bottom, right? So what happened ultimately was what?
All Israel have transgressed thy law.
So we broke them. We chose the curses. So let's go back and see now, Sister April, how is it that the Spirit of God bears witness with you? Read 45 again.
Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 46. And they shall be upon thee for a sign and for a wonder, and upon thy seed forever. Verse 45. Moreover, all these curses shall come upon thee.
Hold up. April, it says all these curses have come upon us. Why? What did all Israel do? Did they keep the commandments or break it? What did we just read in Daniel? They broke it. So read 45 again. You're absolutely correct, April. Read.
Moreover, all these curses shall come upon thee and shall pursue thee.
So all these curses have come upon us and pursue. Meaning, doesn't matter where we go, we travel to. Throughout the four corners of the world, we can go to Asia, Africa, South America, North America. Doesn't matter where, the curses will be there. You following April? Read.
And overtake thee.
Overtake us mean what? We will be full of the curses. Right? Read.
Till thou be destroyed.
Till we be what?
Destroyed.
Till we be destroyed as a nation of people. Read on.
Because thou hearkenest not unto the voice of the Lord thy God.
And the reason curses are upon us till we are destroyed is because we did not listen to the warning of God. He said, if you keep the commandments, you will be blessed and ruling. If you break them, you will be cursed and be on the bottom or be destroyed, right? Read.
To keep his commandments and his statutes, which he commanded thee.
Read.
And they shall be upon thee.
So God says, this is the point. The curses shall be upon the children of Israel in 2020. Read.
For a sign,
April. Meaning, for example, look across the street. There's a big sign that's orange and black. It says cosmetic house. So we know by looking at that building, it's a cosmetic house based on the sign, right? So God says the curses will be upon his people to know, oh, these are the Israelites. In 2020. You understand that? You follow me? Read.
And for a wonder. And upon their seed forever.
So April, check out one of the curses, right? Give me to the line of 68. Let me show you something real quick.
Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 68. And the Lord shall bring thee into Egypt again with ships.
So Moses said, one of the curses is the nation of Israel will be returned to Egypt again. Now I have a question. What was the conditions of Israel, of the Israelites in Egypt? What position were they in on the Egyptians? You remember? The Israelites. They were slaves, correct. So, Sister April, she answered correctly. They were slaves, but it's not, we can't go by Sister April's words of mine. Let's go into the Bible and see what God says. Let's go into the record and see what were the conditions of God's people on the Egyptians, because you must understand the type of God is, how God is. He will put his children into hard bondage for disobedience. You understand what I'm saying? Just like when our children get out of line, we punish them. So guess what? God does the same thing. Read that.
This is Exodus chapter 20, verse 2. I am the Lord thy God, which have brought thee out of the land of Egypt.
To say for you, all right?
Yeah.
All right, so Satan, see, the word is so powerful, spirits start activating now because the truth is coming out of broader market. All right, listen good, sis, listen good. Read it again.
This is Exodus chapter 20, verse 2. I am the Lord thy God, which have brought thee out of the land of Egypt.
So he said, I am the Lord thy God, talking about the Israelite, which have brought thee out of the house of what?
The house of Egypt, out of the house of bondage.
House of what?
Of bondage.
So the Israelites were slaves in Egypt. So the curse was, if you don't keep my commandments, I'm going to bring you back into the conditions of bondage. bondage, slavery. So if you guys are wondering what God is talking about, in 1492, the conquistadors, the Spaniards, came to this side of the world and colonized the native Indians. They sold their land for rape, murder, and they took them and enslaved them to cultivate the land here and put them on ships and transported them back to Europe. In the 1600s, the Negroes from the west coast of Africa, they rounded us up and did the same thing.
This is Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 68. And the Lord shall bring thee into Egypt again with ships.
So, Sister April, what would be the means of transportation? God says he's going to bring us into bondage again by how?
By what?
With ships. By ships, sis. What you looking at from the period of 1492 to 1865, the transatlantic slave trade was going on. Where our people was rounded up on slave cargo ships packed like produce. And we were transported throughout the four corners of the world. Because God says this, the signs will be upon you for who you are in 2020. Now, there's only three groups of people that can relate to the records of God. The so-called Negroes, the so-called Native Indians, and the so-called Latinos. Because this event happened to our people only. So what God is saying is we are the nation of Israel. Because God said the curses will only come upon his children. These things cannot account for this in their record. The Chinese cannot account for this in their record. The Arabs can't account for this in their record. The Europeans with their little fake Holocaust cannot account for this in their record. So there's a problem now. The signs is pointing towards us. April, we are the children of God, April. You understand? Let's get more. We
and the Lord shall bring thee into Egypt again with ships. By the way, Lord, I speak unto thee.
So just like God recorded it here in Deuteronomy, all the curses from slavery paid out just like God said, because the scriptures cannot be broken. That's all we know there's a God. Who can prophesy thousands of years of us and it happens just the way God said it would? That's what power is.
He, thou shalt see it no more again, and there ye shall be served unto your enemies.
So God says, Sister April, what's your name?
Correct.
God says when those ships dock on the west coast of Africa, North America, Asia, Europe, so on and so forth, what will happen?
And there you shall be sold unto your enemy.
God says when those slave ships dock, what will happen? You will be sold to your enemies. We will auction off. You're going to the Caribbean to Master Charles. You're going to Alabama, to Rochester. You understand what I'm saying? You're going to China to the Sing and Ming Dynasty. You're going to Tambu in India. We were auctioning over those slave ship docks. But the point I want you to understand, God says we will be sold on to you. Let's read that again.
And there you shall be sold unto your enemies.
God said, we shall be sold unto our enemies. You know what God says?
Bring it out.
Never our enemies. Brothers and sisters, these are our record. God is telling you how these nations think about us. You wonder why we keep getting killed at an alarming rate and nothing is being done? Because God says they're your enemies. But we don't want to accept that. No, 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 they're not. They're our friends. So this is what God says in the record. Read.
Sirach, chapter 12, verse 10. Never trust thine enemy.
No, that can't be the Bible. What did God say?
Never trust thine enemy.
So I'm going to make it plain. God says don't trust these other nations. That's what he's telling you. But we don't want to listen to God. No, we don't know what he's talking about. I'm going to go about my feelings and my emotions because I know better than God. We keep getting killed and we're like, yo, what's going on here? They saw the same thing we saw and the cops are not guilty? Why? Because we trust our enemies. We didn't get sick into their mind.
Never trust thine enemy.
So God says never trust thine enemy. He sounds like a dude. We're going to go in. See, that's what we need to learn. We never learned the Bible. We learned your European oppression and slavery for 400 years. We could not read or write. So they told us what, exactly what they needed to tell us to maintain their rulership over us. Because when it comes to other nations, you notice how we're a little merciful. But you notice that these people have stolen our wealth. Out to the level of animals.
That's right.
They just literally leave us like pets. You are Guyanese. You are a Puerto Rican. You're Dominican. They leave us like pets. In 2020, we got the flag and we're proud of it. That's how destroyed we are. God says, do not trust your enemies, but we don't want to hear it. Read. This is Psalm chapter 83, verse 1. Keep not thy silence, O God. Hold not thy peace. This is one of our forefathers, King David. Because again, we can't relate to royalty because that's how far we have fallen. We are dead, destroyed, that we don't say, wait a minute. Who were we before slavery? I know we were slaves. Then we had a rebellion. We had the civil rights movements. I got that, but wait a minute. Who were we before slavery? They're not teaching that in the school because guess what? The school is part of the oppressive system. The school's job is to maintain the visual that they want you to understand. You blacks and Latinos are nothing. You're beneath us. And your job is to get educated. And always remember, you go to college and come work for us. Don't create your own business. Your job is to be the workforce. That's it. Read. Hold not thy peace and be not still, O God. The Lord, thine enemies, make it to know. So our forefather David was pissed off. He said, God, they owe you peace. Because our enemies are making it to know. They're having their Lord's gathering. That's a commotion going on. Read. And they that hate thee have lifted up their head. Listen to what God says. The nations that hate God's people also hate God. Think about that. That's like you got a son, my brother. Somebody come to fetch your son in front of your house. If they hate your son, do they hate you too? Exactly. So that God, that's what God is saying. The nations that hate God's people, that means you hate the parents as well. You hate God. That's the missing link that we don't understand. Read. And those that hate thee have lifted up their head. Meaning, look, these nations among us have become proud. They openly mock us. You had your body said, you ain't black if you vote for me. That's disrespectful as hell. They telling you how valid you are with your race or whatever you associate with. Oh, you ain't black if you vote for me. Meaning, bro, you better always vote Democrat. That's what he's saying. So if anybody don't vote for the Democratic Party, you ain't black. That's disrespectful as hell. Read. The Lord taken crafty counsel against thy people. God says, the nation, your enemies, brother, have taken crafty counsel against us. So what do you think politics is? All the laws that they pass, it's not for our benefit, brother. They defund our communities to keep it where it's at, destroyed. When your society is undefended, you can't have a good educational system. My brother, you following me? My sister, you following me? We and consulted against thy hidden ones. They have said, come and let us cut them off from being a nation.
Brother, you hear what the nations came together and said? What we're reading right here is the record of our demise. Nations came together who hate God and hate God's people. And the sole reason of them coming together is to what?
They have said, come and let us cut them off from being a nation.
They destroyed our nationhood, our culture, our customs. So 2020, we don't know who we are anymore. And we quickly want to labels. Oh, you're African American. So I'm two continents named after two white men. Because Africa comes after Scipio Africanus, an Italian navigator, right? Then America is named after Amerigo Vespucci, another Italian navigator. So when we say we're African American, we're saying we descend, black people descend from two white males. That's how foolish we are. But that's what we gotta understand. If the system is an oppressive system, brother, follow me, right? Does it make sense for us as a people to use the oppressive system to liberate ourselves? So the brother said no, he's absolutely correct. So that's why y'all should not be voting. You're gonna use the oppressive system to free yourself, to get rights? Brother, that makes sense to you? You know what I'm saying? You can go to your enemy for help. That makes sense to you, brother? Because the thing is, my brother,
My brother, wait a minute before you walk away. You got to understand before you, I got to give you why we're out here. Because we're warning people. This is not just something that's good to hear.
Oh, yeah, I know.
Judgment is coming.
I know you're telling the truth, you know.
But the thing is, we come out here to let you know what you're doing wrong so we can fix it. Right? Luke 13 and 5, because just give me one more minute. Luke 13 and 5. Because we're not out here to come and just push you guys out of our care. We are here to save lives. We're warning people because judgment is coming. Read. This is Luke chapter 13, verse 5. I tell you, nay, but except you repent, you shall all likewise perish. So, my brother, what's your name again?
Torre.
So this is Christ speaking. He says, unless you repent, you're going to perish, meaning you're going to be put to death. Right? And it's not going to be a quick death, Torre. You're going to be in that state of burning forever. The scripture says you're gonna wish you can die, but you can't because you're immortal in that state. But Tori, the solution is to return to God's commandments.
Right.
That's the solution. Right. You understand what I'm saying? So before you go, I'm gonna show you one love because I see Tori. Believe it or not, you got a beard.
Yeah.
Right? Give me Anti-Corinthians real quick, 11. It's going forward. When the word of God is coming, this is a law that we didn't learn. It's very simple. Let's see if you can catch it. 11.
This is 1 Corinthians chapter 11, verse 3. But I would have you know that the head of every man is Christ.
Torah, God is a God of order. So with the commandments, the point of the laws he gave us is for us to be in order as a people. When you look at our community, the trash on the ground and all that, we're out of order. Because God knows we are people that need laws to govern us. Because we'll join and follow anything. That's why he calls us sheep. We will follow anything. That's our nature. You understand? So that's why he gave us laws to govern us. The laws wasn't given to all nations. We were supposed to be the ones that's enforcing God's laws to all the other nations. But because we're out of order, the nations are running loose.
And the head of the woman is the man.
So the head of the woman is the man. Right? Read.
And the head of Christ is God.
So Christ is the head of the man. The man is the head of the woman. And the head of Christ is who?
God.
So there's a power. There's God the Father, then there's God the Son, which is Christ, then there's God the man, which is us, and then it's the women, right? So that's the order that God set up. And the head of the children are the women. That's the order, right? But society said, no, I'm going to put the woman above the man. Because notice, you don't hear, I'm a strong Chinese woman. You don't hear that. You don't hear, I'm a strong East Indian woman.
Right.
I'm a strong European woman.
Right.
It's only what? The blacks, the Hispanics, and the natives that say that.
Yeah.
And guess what? Their family structure is destroyed
right.
because it's out of order.
Yeah.
So that may sound nice to the women, but God says, I set up that order for a reason. I created you and know what's best suited for you.
Right.
You understand what I'm saying? Well, check this out.
Every man praying or prophesying.
So God says because of that order, we got to respect the level above, right? So above men is Christ, right?
Having his head covered.
So when the scriptures is coming out, the Bible's being read to you. What? Read it again.
Having his head covered. Dishonoreth his head.
So when the scriptures is coming out, for a man to have his head covered, you're dishonoring Christ, our head, and also God. You know what I'm saying? You got that, Tori?
Yeah.
So repentance, because remember Christ said, unless you repent, you shall likewise what? Perish, meaning die. So now that you read that law, what should you do going forward? The Bible's being read right now. What should you do?
Obey it, you know?
And how would you obey that?
Do the right thing.
Which is what? What do you just read? When the Bible's being read out, right? What should a man do? Should a man cover his head or uncover his head? Let's read it again. You missed it. Listen good, Tori.
Every man praying or prophesying, having his head covered, dishonor his head.
Read on.
But every woman that prayeth or prophesieth with her head uncovered, dishonoreth her head.
So God says, when the woman is listening to the scriptures, right, and her head is uncovered, she dishonors the man, her husband, Christ, our Savior, and God the Father, the Almighty Power, right? So from the man level, God says, the men that are listening to the scripture with their head covers, dishonoring Christ the Savior, which is God the Son, and then God the Father. So you as a man, what God is saying. say, Tori, when the Bible is coming out and you're being taught the Bible, it's a shame for you to have your head covered, brother. Take off the hat. That's what God is saying.
Oh, okay.
You see what I'm saying? And likewise for the woman. Those who had her covered, uncovered, they must cover their head. So Tori, go back to Luke 13 and 5. So Tori, repentance, remember, this is what Christ said, I'm reading to you again. Read.
This is Luke chapter 13, verse 5. I tell you, nay, but except ye repent, ye shall all likewise perish.
So what repentance means, Tori, is for you to stop doing that behavior. The scripture is coming out, so repentance will be something as you, oh, I didn't know that, Lord. Took off your hat. You understand, Tori?
Yeah, yeah.
You know you still got a hat on your head, though, right?
Yeah.
Now look around you.
Yeah.
Look around you, Tori, look around you.
Okay.
You see? And this is the problem with our people. I just want to show you something. This is how prideful we have come. We have no respect for God anymore. What is that? Before the world was all obeyed in Esdras. Find that for me. I'm going to show you how it happened. Before the world was, they all obeyed. It might be Esdras 9 or 3. Second Esdras 9 and 19? 18. But I'm going to show you something. We have become so disobedient to God. We have no respect for the Creator who's in charge of life and death. We have become so prideful, we have no respect for Him. To take off a hat, it's funny. You go to the court, you take off your hat. And you walk in the courtroom.
Right.
But when it comes to God, nah, I'm good. Show me how society has designed us to hate God. That's what happened to us. We got no respect because they say, yo, there's no God. And we believe that. Read that.
This is 2nd Esdras, chapter 9, verse 18.
Yeah.
And now we're not prepared to hurt.
So God says, when He was preparing, meaning before He started making the creation in 6 days and He rested on the seventh, what happened?
Which was not yet made, even for them to dwell in.
So before the world was created, for Him to put us in our fleshly bodies, right? What happened?
That now live, no man spake against me.
So what God is saying, before the world, you see the sun, the moon, the earth, the trees and all that, we existed in the spiritual form. And God says we all obey. Every spirit obey.
Read. So then, everyone obey. But now, the manners of them which are created in this world, that is.
Wait, we gonna read it slow. But God says, when we are all in the spiritual form, God says to go left, we all move left. God says go right, we all move right. But let's see what happened when He created the world and created us, our fleshly vessel, and put our spirit in it. Let's see what happened.
So then, everyone obey.
Read.
But now, of the manners of them which are created in this world,
read it slow. The manner of them that are created in this world is talking about flesh, bones, ligaments, the fleshly body that holds the spirit. Read.
That is made are corrupted.
But
the flesh is a corrupted vessel. Because guess what? You could be hungry, right? You're hungry. You don't have any money. Now, you know, yo, I'm really starving. I see something right there. I can steal it. You know stealing is wrong, but you're like, man, I'm really hungry. And you will take it. If you're in the spiritual realm, you're not hungry. Show you. So, for example, there's a lot of married men who cheat on their wives. Right? The law says thou shalt not commit adultery. But what happened is, through the fashion, women walk around half naked. So, sisters, what you don't understand, everything is a ripple effect. God says for you to dress modestly, cover up yourself. But today, everybody out here is completely naked. But you see, there's nothing hidden anymore. All the fashion is sexy, dress sexy. Show your hips, your breasts, your thighs, your ass, all that, right? So, from women dressing like that, what it does is it entices the men. And you all know that because before you leave the house, y'all turn and look back. Y'all make sure it's very tight, so you see your curves of your body. You make sure your bra is pushing up, so your breasts could be out. And then you wear that cleavage so everything shows. But what you don't understand, the reason why God says, corrupt sisters, and He says, that's for your husband, is when you come out, it entices entices the man. God knows what he created in you women. He knows. That's why he says, you women are the apple of the man's eye. He knows how beautiful you are, right? That's what he looks for the men. But the point is, when you dress like that, the brother could be married, and when he sees you every day, you start enticing to the point where now he goes and he lays down with you. So it's a ripple effect. But read it again. Which are created in this world that is made, all corrupted by a perpetual seed. So God says, in this world, we are corrupted by a perpetual seed. Because when God created us, he gave us laws to govern us, for us to refrain from the wickedness. But there's always been a nation that was the front runner that are, give me that local fame. We're going to bring it out today. Hold this real quick and give me that Esau in Hebrews. None more profane than Esau. You got to understand, God created, according to the records, 18 nations, right? Of all the nations, one of them was the great wicked on this earth. And God is going to list the characteristics because we say, wait, we don't recognize these names because when we were destroyed, the nation changed the nationalities. Because think about it. If the biblical names still were placed on the nation today, we would see Esau. Oh, Esau is the right. They're the damn wicked. So they have to hide that. Right? So this is what God says about the perpetual seed. Read.
Hebrews chapter 12, verse 16. Lest there be any fornicator or profane person as Esau.
So God says Esau and his descendants are profane. And what?
Lest there be any fornicator or profane person as Esau.
What it means by fornicator? It's all sex, 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 sex with this nation. Man and woman, we said, nah, I'm too profane for that. I'm going to make men and men, women and women. I'm going to push that. But he said, nah, 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 nah. That's not enough for me. I'm going to do grown adults and little babies. Then he said, nah, 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 nah. That's not enough. I'm going to push man and dog, cat, fish, snake, whatever, because he's profane. Again, we're just reading the Bible. God shows you the characteristics of our nation. So Esau, there's a nation that's pushing this sex, 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 sex. Now, God created male and female. 2020, this profane nation now is transgender, there's a transgender, gender neutral, lesbianism, queer. I lost count. I don't even know anymore. Because we're so profane, we keep pushing the envelope. Now, pedophilia is legal in California. What do you think it's going to be in a few more years? We have the states. But our people are asleep. Got it? So now, that same profane person, let's see God, what God says about the spirit in these nation of people. Because on the earth, there is a nation of people that have no morals. And our job is to reveal the great wicked on this earth from the word of God, because before Christ returned, the great wicked must be revealed. Because we're on the spell. All the violence and stuff that's going on in society, we like, I don't know what's going on. Now, why do you get killed? It's about equality. All this is coming together. God is never about equality and integration. And we're going to read that. Read.
Habakkuk chapter 2, verse 4. Behold, his sword, which is lifted up, is not upright in him, but the just shall live by his faith.
God says the soul of this nation is not upright in him. Give me another repetition. Let me give you an example. The measuring to know that a nation don't have a right soul in them. You can see on a video, right? A woman is sleeping in a house. The cops are shooting in the building from all different sides, right? The woman gets killed in her sleep. They looked at all those rounds, looked at how much killed the woman, looked at the wall. Well, these five bullets hit the wall. The cops did nothing wrong for the woman who was sleeping in her own house. They did nothing wrong, but that wall, how dare they hit that wall? That's an example that somebody's spirit is not right in them. They can't understand morality. Yo, an innocent woman just got killed. Damn, that's wrong. When your spirit isn't right, you can't understand that. Give me in Deuteronomy. Yeah, give that first.
This is Lamentations, chapter 4, verse 17. Verse 18. hunt our steps, that we should not go in our streets. Our end is near, our days are fulfilled, for our end is come.
So God says, there's a nation calling right now. There's calling of people that's being haunted. They can't leave their house doing regular stuff. Right now, for a Latino or a Negro to go get gas or groceries, they might not return home. Because we're seeing it's more frequent now that our people are being murdered for doing everyday things. They're not criminals. They get pulled over from coming back from the movies, coming from getting groceries, getting gas. They're getting shot. They're getting murdered unjustly, unarmed. And the courts look at them and say, the cops did nothing wrong. The police were justified in killing Fidel Castillo. In front of his wife and his child, a law-abiding citizen with a purchase, a license to carry a gun. They shot him in front of his kids on camera. And they said, the prosecutor said, oh, we did nothing wrong. Because while there's spreaders around them, give me anything wrong and tell me they have no regard for the old or the young. We're going to bring it out because the Bible is our place of comfort. The truth will set us free. We must understand, brothers and sisters, that we have enemies. The nation hates our gut. Read.
This is Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 50. A nation of a fierce countenance, which shall not regard the person of the old, nor show favor to the young.
So God says there's a nation on this earth that have no respect to person. They don't care, they'll kill you. They don't care if you're an old woman. What's that little kid that got shot with the gun? The city. Tamir Rice was 7, right? How old is he? Was 12 years old playing with a toy gun. They rolled up and lit that kid up without even identifying what he really had. So God is telling you, the nation of Edom, the so-called Europeans today, read it again.
A nation of a fierce countenance.
You know what it means, fierce? They are brutal. That's how you can see people keep getting killed innocently, and they say, oh, the cops are not wrong. No prosecution. So all they're saying is, yo, keep killing these Negroes and Latinos. Keep killing them. That's what they're saying. Read.
But shall not regard the person of the old, nor show favor to the young.
And they will have no care whether you are a young Latino or a Negro or a Native Indian, or you're a teenager, or you're a grown adult. At the end of the day, all they see is prey. You understand? Because, last one, group 3-8. Because what you so-called blacks, Hispanics, and Native is must understand, you are not free. You are fully destroyed. They took off the yokes of iron from our necks while we were fully programmed.
Right. Read. This is Baruch, chapter 3, verse 8. Behold, we are yet this day in our captivity.
Brother, you hear what God said? We are still in our captivity this day. That's why you see our people are getting killed on camera. And prosecutors and the judge, the legal system look at this and say, oh, the cops did nothing wrong. They're totally justifying killing a woman in her sleep. That woman that was sleeping in her own home, she was guilty. She was in the wrong. You understand what I'm saying to you? Read it again.
Behold, we are yet this day in our captivity.
Meaning, the other nations still see us as 3/5 a man that's in the Constitution that's governing this country. We're still not equal to them. We're 3/5 of a man. We're not human beings. That's where the Latinos and the Native Indians and the Negroes can be killed and nothing is being done. You understand? We're coming out here to teach us our true nationality before slavery. We are God's people. And the reason we're being afflicted and cursed and killed is because we continually break God's laws. He made a covenant with us. We keep his laws, he protects us, and we rule this world. We break them, we'll be below our nations and constantly be oppressed. You understand?
We used to scream black power while Heron was pushed. But at the end of the day, nothing's in vain. IUIC has been given a vision. The tents of Judah has risen. Many has attempted the mission, minor murmuring, omitting, and missing the mark. Just reading that he had the flame of fire in his eyes gave us the spark. We on Paul's mission. We out on the road, purple and gold, from Mexico, Cuba, Haiti, Ghana, Sierra Leone. 144,000 boots banging, concrete crackling. These are how our men repented at heart. The scriptures is proof. IUIC, we deliver the truth.